Hello, little dragon. What are you doing in there? Just couldn't do with this switching away from tap water, huh? So you go chasing us into the good water. It's kind of a shit move on your part. You know, when you're uninvited guest, you leave. You don't sneak back into the chamber, the wine cellar of a party, and you're like, hi, I'm just, reading old books. No, dude, you go and you make your own party somewhere else. And again, this is a pretty epic video. For that. Oh, did you just put in half? Oh, lovely. Alright, well, with everyone come forward then. We're fucked. Oops. What we can expect from our water. So he left his, or she left her jellyfish coat over there and is now, sorry, it's crooked, skinny dipping over here. Oh, and then there's another friend, I think, or that could be, that one could be a dent in the side of the container, but then again, never underestimate a dragon. It's a weird shape. Camera. Why can't you autofocus anymore? Oh my. Thank you for not necessitating being ripped from my arm or face this time, at least not to my knowledge. And this is further proof this disease, this infection is coming from water. So this water came from NK drinking water on 10th Street in Long Beach. My advice to her is, get off the phone. She does a nice job of keeping it clean in there, though, so I can't really say that this is her fault, but I don't know, does she know how to clean her own tanks? You know, this is coming from somewhere gross. I know that because I stayed somewhere so gross. And all gross things come from gross things. So. What's up, dragon? I like that shape the best, although you're kind of a dick at that shape, you know, because you don't do that. Okay, now pro camera's deciding to be an asshole. Because it does not like having fixed ranges in front of its shutter. Backstroke around the water bottle. Someone came in and shook it all up. That would be me. Okay, so to all the delusional. It's blurry. Just tuck this feather in your hat and think to yourself, could that be in my water? When was the last time I scrubbed absolutely everything every day for a year? Or just, I don't know, scrubbed out my water bottles last time. Because maybe you should check. Because otherwise, I'm gonna call you delusional. I'll be like, oh, I don't know. I don't see it. What, I don't know what you're talking about, girly. Also, unfortunately, is the fact that I'm out of really anything to put this thing in. You know what would be super funny? Is if I brought it to the CDC and they were like, it's nothing. It's a piece of fluff. What do you think? Should I simultaneously send this to the news and to CDC and see if maybe then they'll, come clean? Because let me tell you guys, I'm seeing these in the tap water almost every day. The same water we bathe in, wash our clothing in, wash our dishes in. A lot of people drink from. Night after night, I'll be cleaning my wounds, hearing someone vomit in my building. It just breaks my heart. And I don't know if they know what what's the cause of it or what, and it's not my business. But if they don't know, similar to how I have not, you know, been in the know about what's going on with my health for so long, and I've had people who are, you know, purposefully gaslighting me, contribute to that. Those are the type of people I want to just share some of this with. And say, have you looked at this? Have you looked at that? Do you need my help? Because apparently I can see things that not everyone can unless it's like really presented to them. And I appreciate the rare few who have come around, like the vet. Thank you, vet. Lost her for a while and her whole office, who rather savagely turned on me, and Monzies. When Mamageddon went in and attempted to spread her propaganda. Let's remember patient files are confidential. What are you doing, dude? You getting lazy and listening to me? You got all bent when I interrupted your movie this morning in my toilet. Oh yeah, why'd you see that one, you guys? I mean, the balls on these guys these days, at least around me, they're like, eh, we're not even about to hide it anymore. Eh, we're coming out. Ready or not, here we come. I think the people I feel worse of all for, though, are the people who are really struggling, at least in my city. There's such a high number of people who are struggling financially and don't have a secure place to live or a safe place to stay, and I've heard that they're becoming more and more afflicted with these parasites, and people don't believe them because of their situation, and that really pisses me off because it's the fucking parasite that put them in the situation, or, you know, contributed to the worsening of the situation, and therefore is what is precluding them from getting help from this parasite. See? Yeah, that's called an Ouroboros. A snake eating its tail. Also, I have coined, at least in my humble estimation, an insurmountable obstacle. You know, it's these criteria or conditions that people put up in front of you as a qualifier to provide that what you're asking for, help or assistance or whatever. But then, you know, they purposefully make it something that you could never do. Oh, look at scary you. Colorful. Is that, a reflection of what's behind you? Are you eating something? Looks like you're eating more goo. I don't know how they can tell the difference between their goo and this other goo. I wish iPhones weren't such shitty cameras. Oh, that's your net. Oh, fuck. Oh, yep, and that thing is cutting your net. Let's see this on the in the microscope yesterday. They had a net of what looked like, you know, jellyfish. I think I'm making the counter shake. Interesting is like still looks like a dragon, but she has tucked herself up in such a way that I look like a stealth bomber. Completely parasitized this entire bottle. Okay, so this water here at the bottom appears to be circulating. And let your eyes adjust. Like, oh, Morty. Yeah, this thing sucks. See? See the three lights and then the two? Don't be mistaken. Remember your patterns. Granted, it is moving with the surface water and not the globbies. Dragon's watching me to see if I figure this out. See? Mm-hmm. Oh, you hear me. never alone. I guess. Anyway, better catch this guy and figure out where Shahi's supposed to be. And put on my gloves first. I'm excited to share this with the Morgellons Science Support Group on Facebook. Sorry if I got that wrong. But if you guys have not joined, they're a really, really kind group of people who are really, really happy to share what they've learned and listen to people who are new. They've been really a very supportive change in my life, and I really appreciate them, so I can't wait to share this with them and hope this helps and see if anyone else has anything similar, because definitely making a statement like this is in our water needs to be corroborated by other people and figured out, you know, that'll help inform the source. Mr. and Mrs. Dude are getting ready to twist or change you, so here we come. Oops, interesting shape, my friend. And then at this point, this organism is probably, I want to say 3/4 of an inch to 1.25 inches long, and pretty wide at this point, so it's like at least 1/4 of an inch wide to whatever the next one up from that is. I don't know, I was never good at fractions, so anyway. Checks out. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and hit the like and hit the bell so you know when there's more videos coming out. And watch, because YouTube, they want you, like, you know, plugged in to the vein and downloading all this content to your brain and sharing with your friends and saying, see, I'm not crazy. Just like she did. So yeah, I'll back you up. All right, guys. Be well. Be safe. Thanks.